For years, those of us navigating the world of Sjogren's disease, the dryness, the fatigue, the body pain, the systemic complications have heard the same frustrating sentence. There are no FDA-approved treatments specifically for Sjogren's disease. We've managed the symptoms with a patchwork of approaches, but we haven't had a targeted therapy designed to address the underlying immune system dysfunction of our disease. And today, that narrative is finally starting to change. Hi, everyone. My name is Dr. Kara Wada. I am a quadruple board certified allergy, immunology, lifestyle medicine physician, certified life coach, and I'm someone who lives with Sjogren's disease and dysautonomia. And I am so excited to share some incredibly exciting news today with everyone who's tuning in. This is the kind of news our community has been waiting for a very, very long time. We have had a huge milestone in the clinical trials that are ongoing for multiple medications that are specifically geared to treating Sjogren's disease. Just this past week, we've had positive phase 3 trial results from Novartis and in their trials for Ianalumab. Novartis announced just last week that their phase 3 clinical trials for Ianalumab were successful, and this is massive news. Both of their large global phase 3 trials named NEPTUNUS-1 and NEPTUNUS-2, they always have such creative names, met their primary goals. We're going to break down what that means and how in these rigorous scientific studies, Ianalumab showed a statistically significant improvement in disease activity for patients with Sjogren's disease compared to those who received the placebo medication. This is the first time ever that a medication has shown this level of success in a phase 3 clinical trial for Sjogren's disease. It's a huge milestone, and it paves the way for Ianalumab to potentially become the very first FDA-approved targeted treatment for our condition. So how does Ianalumab work? Gosh, it's a mouthful. Let's take a quick scientific dive into how this medication works and what makes Ianalumab so special. It is a really cool dual mechanism of action. We know that in Sjogren's, a type of immune cell called the B cell plays a major role in the autoimmune attack. Ianalumab targets these B cells in two different ways. One, it causes B cell depletion. It helps remove some of the overactive B cells that are causing problems from the system. It also is a BAFF-R inhibitor. It blocks a key survival signal for these B cells called BAFF, and it blocks through that receptor, and it's like cutting off the fuel supply or the fertilizer to these cells. So these B cells cannot continue on in their development and make it to the point where they then are able to create and produce autoantibodies, which are a main source of the autoinflammation that's driving Sjogren's disease. By targeting the problem in these two different ways, it offers a powerful approach to calming down that misguided immune response that causes our Sjogren's symptoms. The best part, the press release also mentioned that Ianalumab was well tolerated and had a favorable safety profile in these trials, which is, you know, one of our big things that we want to think about. When we talk about starting any kind of medication, we always want to know what are the risks and what are the benefits and what is the likelihood that this medication is going to help improve my symptoms and my quality of life. So what does this mean for our Sjogren's community? This isn't just a win for Novartis. Certainly it is. And I would suspect their stock prices probably went up, but this is a win for us. It's a win for every single person who has felt dismissed, who has struggled to find relief, and who has waited very patiently, or maybe not so patiently, for science to catch up to what we've needed. Having an FDA-approved treatment would be a game changer in that it would, one, validate our experience. It sends a powerful message to the entire medical community that Sjogren's is a serious systemic disease that deserves targeted and effective treatments, just as patients with rheumatoid arthritis, patients with lupus, patients with myasthenia gravis, right? Sjogren's is in a similar vein as these other conditions. It also provides us a new tool. It gives doctors and patients a new evidence-based option to manage the disease and not just the symptoms. And It will spur more research. Success breeds success. We've seen this happen time and time again within areas of medicine surrounding rheumatoid arthritis, asthma, lupus. This milestone will likely encourage even more investment in research into other potential therapies for Sjogren's disease. So what happens next? How does this go from these great results to the road to approval? So Novartis plans to present the full data from these trials at an upcoming medical conference. After that, they will submit their findings to health authorities like the FDA here in the United States and similar bodies around the world for approval process. This process can take time, but Ianalumab has already been granted fast track designation by the FDA, which can sometimes help speed that bureaucratic process along a little bit. We'll be watching very, very closely for updates on that process. I want to end by sharing a personal reflection as a trial participant and a hopeful advocate. As many of you know, I am currently participating in a different clinical trial, phase 3 clinical trial for Sjogren's. It's the OASIS trial and dazodalibep. And this news fills me with so much hope. It reinforces why participating in research is so incredibly important. It's because of the hundreds of patients who volunteered for the NEPTUNUS 1 and 2 trials that we are at this pivotal moment today. This news strengthens my resolve and my passion for helping all of you navigate this journey. And it's a reminder that we're not just managing a condition, we are part of a community that is actively fighting for a better future. If you want to learn more about the thoughts I had, the questions I asked, that process that I underwent in thinking through my own participation in the trial and the updates, we'll link to those prior episodes down below in the show notes. And if speaking of the future, I have a quick important reminder about my practice, the Immune Confident Institute. As we announced last week, we're just about 2 weeks away from launching our enhanced new patient experience. As a reminder, starting September 1st, every new patient evaluation will include a complimentary 1 month of our Immune Confident Institute membership access period. This gives you dedicated support right after your visit when we're doing labs, making some pretty quick adjustments to lifestyle and other maybe medications. And so this really helps allow us to increase that level of support so there's no more feeling lost or anxious while waiting for those next steps. To reflect this incredible new value, our pricing will be updated on September 1st. So you have about 2 weeks left to book your consultation at our current legacy pricing. So if you've been on the fence thinking about wanting to start a journey with us, this is a wonderful opportunity to begin at our original rates. Don't wait. The link to learn more and to schedule your visit to make sure you're in a place that I am clinically licensed will be in the description below. Let's get you on that path to feeling more immune confident. And in the meantime, let's celebrate this moment together. What are your thoughts on this incredible news? How does it make you feel about the future of Sjogren's treatment? I'd love to hear your excitement, your hesitations, your questions, all in the comments below. This is a huge step forward for our community. And please, please, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for more updates like this. Until next time, in good health, take care.